a long way, basically. But today, we're going to look at different running events that you can do for fun. Now, if it's raining, and we really hope it doesn't rain, it's become beautiful weather at the moment. If it is raining, and you're indoors, and you've got enough room, you can move things out of the way, and you've got a little bit of room in your living room, okay, you can do this. Otherwise, try and get outside. Okay, set yourself up a little course and go outside and do it if you can. All right, stay safe all the time. You don't want anything in your way because you don't want to trip over it. Okay, so you need, when you set out for a course, you need a nice, clear course with nothing in your way. Second, if it's really wet outside, just be careful because I don't want you to slip and hurt yourselves. So just be mindful of the weather. All right. So, the first thing is a sprint, because you're only going to be running for 10 seconds. And you're going to need a little bit of help here, because somebody is going to need their phone, so they can use their stopwatch on their phone, to time 10 seconds. And you will see how far, how many coordinates you can do, right? So, you've got the starting point. I've just put down my jumper here. And the other end of my course are my trusty socks. So I've got to go to my socks, back to my jumper, to my socks, back to my jumper for 10 seconds and see how many times I can do that. Up to my socks is one, back to my jumper, two. Okay? So all you're going to do is start on the mark, someone will say they'll have their stopwatch, hopefully mum, dad, or brother, or sister will have the stopwatch. On your marks, set, go! 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know if that was 10 seconds, I haven't got anyone helping me. But they will tell you when to stop and you'll count up how many you did. 1, 2, 3, I need 4, I don't know if I'm down to 10 seconds. Write it down, so you've got a target there, haven't you, to try and improve on. Then you're going to run for 30 seconds and see how many you can do in 30 seconds. Have a rest. Write the number down. If there's someone with you, why don't you time them and they can do it as well. So they've got a target that they can try and improve. So you're sort of working together. And then have another rest and run for 2 minutes. Now, 2 minutes is quite a long time. So we've got to think about what pace we're going to set, because you're going to be running there and back for 2 minutes. Hopefully somebody will be timing you and can count for you as well. You can count yourself. But think about your pace judgment. In other words, how fast are you going to be running? You're not running for 10 seconds, you've got to run continuously for 2 minutes. And think about it. Am I going to be running as fast as I did when I ran for 10 seconds? No, probably not. So you've got to think, right, I want to keep going for 2 minutes without walking, without having to stop. So I need to maybe slow down my pace a little bit and judge that pace so I can keep going for 2 minutes. See how many you get. There, here is one, there is back is two. Keep that score, write it down, because it's something then another event you can go back to and try and improve on. Okay? Stay relaxed, nice deep breaths, have your water near you, so you can have, after you finish, you can have a drink of water. Have your inhaler near you, if you use an inhaler, because you may need to use that, so hopefully you won't. But have everything near you in between when you're resting, just in case. Okay, that's the three running events: a sprint, a longer sprint, and an endurance run, we'll call it, a 2 minute endurance run. Now I've got another event. It's this one, I'm going to go back to the pans and pots and everything I used for our crazy goals. So I'll just get in. But no china, no pottery, nothing that's going to smash and break. You're going to hurt yourself. So I'm just using a plastic mixing bowl and a big sort of sandwich box here. So then what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some objects. So these are the objects I used in the morning basically, and I'm going to put them at one end in the box. Now this running event is all about how long it takes me to put the objects from one box into another. Now, don't worry about the noise. That's Mr. Welsh doing the gardening outside. He's doing a really good job. He's working really, really hard here to keep the school looking really lovely. Doing lots of jobs around the school. So I hope you can still hear me. Again, you need someone to help you because they're going to time how long it takes you. Alright, everybody can do this well. They will tell me, someone's going to tell me, marks, get set, go, stop watching the phone. See how long you're only allowed, rules, you're only allowed to take one object at a time. Okay, so it'll be like this, something like this, you marks, get set, go. Into the box. Pick up the next one. Back into the box. Next one. Into the box. Next one. Into the box. Stop the clock. Right. Somebody's got to stop the clock. Write down the time that I did. Okay? Now, you've got a target there, haven't you? You can have a rest and do it again. Or you can have a competition against the person that is timing you. They can have a go, see if they can beat your time. You might be thinking, this is much more, what do I do if the ball falls out? Well, that doesn't count. You've got to pick it up, put it in there, then you go and get the next one. If it falls out, you've got to pick it up, put it in, before you go back and get the next object. More rules. If you are going to do this event against someone else, you've got to keep the boxes at the same distance to make it fair. Okay? If you want to do it again, have a break, have a breather, do it again yourself. See if you can do it quicker. Alright? That's another running event. The last one is how many objects can you touch in a minute? Or you can set yourself any time you want actually. It could be half a minute, or 20 seconds. How many objects? And again, I'm using the same objects that I've used for our athletics. Same objects that I've used for the crazy golf, just ordinary objects around the house, but nothing delicate, nothing you can hurt yourself with. So, let's see. I'm going to maybe do 10 seconds. How many objects can I touch in 10 seconds? You can't keep going back to the same one. Okay, I'm going to start by my jumper, so everybody knows this is where I'm starting. One, and come back to the start. Two. I'm working my heart, I'm working my body. to do it easier.
So, don't worry if you're out of breath, it's good.
Now, just remember the rules. Your starting point, you can put your objects wherever you want. Okay, I've just put them here. You can use any object you want, as long as it's safe to use, like a jumper, or a toy, or rolled up socks, or a turned up box. Okay, every time you touch that object, you've got to come back to the start before you go to the next object. Pushing those big muscles in the legs, coming back, using the arms, driving forwards, down low, come back. You have to touch every object, okay? And then if you're doing it for a minute, you have to do that again. Just keep going, hand me objects. And don't always touch the ones that are near you. You've got to touch all of them. So even the ones that are furthest away, touch those. Enjoy it, have fun, and